Kevin Kisner notches a timely victory. Relegation and promotion returns to the tour. James Piot alters his career trajectory. Doug Barron goes nuts and more in this week's edition of Monday Scramble. Kis, for the US Ryder Cup team. It took three questions for a reporter to ask in the post-round presser what the victory did for Kisner's Ryder Cup prospects. Here we go, Kisner said, fully anticipating the line of questioning. I said, how many Ryder Cup questions are we going to have? This wasn't all that surprising, of course. This is the time of year when any result can be extrapolated to boost a respective player's resume in an argument. And a win is apparently valued tenfold now, in the final weeks of auditioning, because they're clutch, and stepping up, and fighting for a spot. No doubt, Kisner is a particularly interesting candidate, given his doggedness, his veteran savvy, his chill demeanor on a team full of divas, and, of course, his match play acumen, as a former WGC champion and runner-up, though this was his first playoff win in six attempts. But as painful as this is to type, Kisner should not go to the front of the line of would-be captain's picks. Not yet, at least. Full credit to him for stepping up and throwing this dart into 18. But he was gifted a second chance in the Wyndham playoff after Adam Scott failed to hit the hole from 4 feet. Club twirl, and though he's trending in the right direction, Kis has only three top tens this year. That's why he's 18th in the standings. And that's why a strong playoffs is needed to seriously justify his selection. Especially considering a brawny venue like Whistling Straits that bears little resemblance to the position-oriented tracks where he's previously found success both this year, TPC River Highlands, Detroit GC, now Sedgefield, and historically, Austin CC, Sea Island, Colonial. It boils down to this. Are there six current non-qualifiers who would be better additions to the team? Jordan Spieth, Harris English and Patrick Reed are obvious. Patrick Cantlay is the world number 9 and a ready-made partner for Xander Schauffele. Daniel Berger has been rock solid this year, boasts one of the most complete games on tour and played on the same President's Cup team as Kisner. Then you have veterans like Webb Simpson and Tony Finau and, ugh, Phil Mickelson, who might fill a need, and promising youngsters like Scotty Scheffler, Will Zalatoris and Sam Burns, who have consistently showed up. So don't listen to the social media chatter. Kisner must do more, much more, over the next few weeks to warrant a spot on Team USA. And Kisner, in fact, seems to agree. Who knows, man? I've never been picked before, so I'm not going to go out there and jump on a limb and say that I'm going to get picked this year. I love Captain Steve Stricker. He's a great friend and a great guy. He'll do what's best for the team and the country. I would love more than anything to represent our country and be a part of that team. I need to play well in these playoffs and continue to show great form. The lanky 34-year-old, in a de facto home game for the Raleigh, North Carolina, native, made his first ever hole in one en route to shooting 62 and sitting on the top 125 cutoff. This is exactly how we'd celebrate our first ace, too. It still didn't look like it'd be enough. Not with fellow bubble boy Justin Rose hunting for the lead, but Rose 3 putted the last, missing a 5-footer, to be the odd man out. I've been on the right side of it, as the 2018 Fed X Cup champion, and on the wrong side today, Rose said. It's not nice when it's not in your hands, but obviously it was in my hands up 18. I didn't do a very good job of that. It was sweet relief for Hadley, who gave this memorable interview with CBS Amanda Baliones afterward, a reminder that the stars are the exception, not the rule, on tour. The game is full of gritty grinders trying to keep at it, and it was an important result for Rose, even if it meant missing the playoffs for the first time since its inception. He's exempt on tour through the 2023-24 season. Needing a good showing to impress European Ryder Cup captain Porrick Harrington, who seems to have narrowed his choices to just a few for one spot, Rose posted his best result, T10, in 3 months. So that's a win-win, even if the results said otherwise. And so, after all of that Sunday drama at the Wyndham, just three players moved inside and outside of the magic number. That follows the trend from the past 7 years, 21 guys, in and out. Over on the Korn Ferry Tour, they also played their regular season finale and handed out PGA Tour cards for the first time since fall 2019. Only 6 of the 25 graduates have played full-time on the PGA Tour before. The rest will be rookies. Here are the 25 guys who will be in the big show beginning next month: Stefan Jaeger, Mito Pereira, Chad Ramey, Taylor Moore, Taylor Pendrith, Grayson Sig, Davis Riley, Jared Wolff, Will Zalatoris, Lee Hodges, Adam Svensson, David Lipsky, Brandon Wu, Max McGreevy, Paul Barjon, Andrew Novak, Dylan Wu, Seth Reeves, Cameron Young, Nick Hardy, Curtis Thompson, David Skins, Ben Coles, Brett Druitt, Austin Smotherman. Some interesting stories in there. Davis Riley is a stud. Jared Wolff began the KFT season with 4 guaranteed starts and wound up earning his full card. Max McGreevy is the poster child for the Tour Feeder System, the PGA Tour China Order of Merit winner, then a KFT graduate. Cameron Young led or co-led after 8 consecutive rounds to earn his card in short order. Curtis Thompson is the older brother of LPGA star Lexi Thompson. David Skins, who won the regular season finale, is a 39-year-old Englishman finally making it big. And Austin Smotherman is a former teammate of Bryson DeChambeau's at SMU. Both players earn invitations to the 2022 Masters and US Open, provided they remain amateur. Piot also gets an extra spot in the Open Championship. For the second year in a row, it was an unlikely championship match. A year after 0 top 50 players advanced to the semi-finals at Bandon Dunes, this finale pitted Piot, a fifth-year senior at Michigan State, against Austin Greiser, a junior at North Carolina who isn't the best player on his upstart squad but had a strong showing a few weeks ago at the Western Amateur, where he lost in the semifinals. The rapid elevation of these two players in particular, and last year's AM at Bandon, is a testament to the high-level parity across the college and amateur game. No player has been able to separate and dominate, but there are, literally, dozens of talented 18 to 22-year-olds who could win any given week. An epic celebration. Trophy.